Buenos días a todos. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for attending this Armistice Day commemoration here in the wonderful setting of the Benalmádena Bilbil Castle. Firstly, I would like to thank the Town Hall for letting us hold this commemoration today. So 105 years ago this very day, the armistice was signed in 1918. And once more, we've all gathered here to remember those who have fallen in conflicts throughout the world. We also remember that conflicts still happen in nowadays, and we hope for peace and reconciliation for all nations in these times of need. Muy buenas a señoras y señores. Me gustaría dar primero la bienvenida al señor alcalde de Benalmádena, Juan Antonio Lara, la primera teniente de alcalde, la señora María de la Presentación Aguilar, también concejala de Turismo y Residentes Extranjeros, además de los diferentes representantes del gobierno local. También contamos hoy con los representantes de diferentes naciones, como la consulada de Estados Unidos, es Bobby Aaron, y la vicecónsul del Reino Unido de Costa del Sol, Miriam Pérez Martín. También contamos además con la asistencia de la Royal British Legion y Prisca Vanier de Francia, junto con los Sur Pipes Band. So once again, may I ask everyone to please turn off your phones. And I'd like to first thank the Mayor of Benalmádena, Juan Antonio Lara, the Councillor for Foreign Residents and Tourism for Benalmádena, Ms. María de la Presentación Aguilar, and the rest of the local town hall team. We also have today with us the Consul of the United States of America, Ms. Bobby Aaron, and the Vice Consul for the Great United Kingdom, Miriam Pérez Martín. We also have with us today the Royal British Legion, members of the Royal British Legion, and France represented by Ms. Prisca Vanier, as well as the Sur Pipes Band. Today is a very solemn occasion, and it really does, it's very emotional to see so many today present with us to remember this Armistice Day. There'll be various different poems read, many words formed, and also 2 minutes silence at 11 o'clock. At the end of the ceremony, there will be a march past led by the pipes, by Mr. Leslie Thompson, and there will afterwards be also some drinks if people would like to join us. So without more ado, can I please present Mr. Neil Toplis from the Royal British Legion, which will say a few words, followed by a minute's silence. Okay, so señoras y señores, ahora le doy la palabra al señor Neil Toplis de la Royal British Legion, seguido por un minuto de silencio.
They shall not grow old as we who are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
Thank you. In Flanders fields, the poppies grow between the crosses, row on row. They mark our place, and in the sky, the larks still bravely singing fly. Scarce heard amidst the guns below. We are the dead short days ago. We lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow. Loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe. To you from failing hands we throw. The torch be yours to hold it high if ye break faith with us who die. We shall not sleep through poppies grow in Flanders fields.
Thank you. Ahora toma la palabra Juan Antonio Lara, alcalde de Benalmádena, junto con la concejala de Turismo y Residentes Extranjeros y teniente de alcaldía, señora Priscila.
Buenos días a todos. Good morning, everybody. Excelentísima señora cónsul del Reino Unido, Miriam Pérez. Excelentísima cónsul de Estados Unidos, Roberta Anón. Concejala de Residentes Extranjeros, compañera Presi Aguilera. Miembros de las distintas comunidades de residentes, amigos, amigas todos, buenos días a todos. Y bienvenidos. Es para mí un honor estar hoy con todos vosotros y compartir esta solemne celebración en lo que es el Día del Recuerdo, en memoria a todas aquellas personas que han perdido sus vidas en los distintos conflictos bélicos que han tenido lugar en todo lo largo de nuestra historia y en todas las partes del mundo. Un día que este año cobra mayor significado, cuando dos grandes conflictos actualmente se están librando y que ellos nos tienen en vilo a todos, que son la guerra de Ucrania y la guerra en el Próximo Oriente. Este día, 11 de noviembre, se conmemora la firma del armisticio que puso fin a lo que fue la Primera Guerra Mundial, por tierra, por mar y por aire. Esa gran guerra que tanto afectó al mundo y que marcó para siempre las historias de las distintas potencias que se vieron en su momento implicadas. We gather today to remember those who died in the First World War. When the armistice was signed on 11 a.m. on 11 November 1918. La Primera Guerra Mundial debió ser la guerra para acabar con todas las guerras, pero como ya sabemos, eso no fue así. This great war should have been the war to end all wars, but it did not. En dos décadas, Europa y el mundo volverían a arder en un conflicto aún más terrible que fue la Segunda Guerra Mundial. Y pensábamos que algo así no se volvería a vivir, pero las guerras continúan, ahora en pleno siglo XXI. Y han vuelto con fuerza. We cannot forget the Second World War and other armed conflicts even today. We also commemorate this today. Es por ello, por lo que en este día, al Día del Recuerdo, cobra un mayor sentido. Porque las guerras no solo son partes del pasado, sino también nuestro presente y también forma parte de nuestro continente. A simple minute's silence once a year, it's very important. Y aunque la ceremonia de hoy quizás no sea común en lo que es nuestro litoral, en lo que es nuestra costa, me llena de satisfacción el compartirla con todos y cada uno de vosotros y vosotras. Ciudadanos de distintas nacionalidades que nos unimos hoy para recordar las víctimas y a las víctimas de los conflictos armados y para levantar la voz pidiendo la paz y la reconciliación en el mundo. We are glad that our neighbors from different countries gathered here today to celebrate this ceremony. Espero que algún día aprendamos de los errores del pasado. Today symbolizes peace and reconciliation. We should learn from mistakes and live together in solidarity with our neighbors. We will remember them. Muchas gracias a todos.
Good morning, Your Excellency, the Mayor of Benalmádena, Mr. Juan Antonio Lara, Your Excellency, the Councils, and all authorities present today. We gather today to remember those who have died during conflicts around the world. The day is marked today because of its origins in the First World War, when the armistice was signed at 11 a.m. on 11 November 1918, ending the Great War. But it also commemorates all those who have suffered in all the conflicts since then. That Great War, which so affected the world, continues to scar nations represented with us today, affecting all their populations. It should have been the war to end all wars, but as we know, it did not. Within 2 decades, Europe and the world would ban again in an even more fearsome conflict, the Second World War. And we must not forget the other conflicts. There are so much talked about, and therefore did not leave the terrible mark on those who lived through them. Even today, we continue to see suffering caused by armed conflicts, which we also commemorate today. A simple minute silence once a year to think of those who suffer, give thanks for that sacrifice, and hope never to see it again, if not asking too much. And although the boy ceremony might not be common on our coast, we are glad that our neighbors from all countries gather here today as a part of this wonderful community in Benalmádena and continue to celebrate this ceremony of remembrance. Today also symbolizes peace and reconciliation between those nations that were once considered enemies. This message is more important than ever, and let us hope that the world will one day learn from those mistakes and we can live together in solidarity with all our neighbors. We will remember them. We will always remember them for their bravery, to charge off the hill knowing they had the lower ground, but still doing it for our lives. As we left the shore, a trumpet sounded to begin our charge up the slope. Most did not make it as they got unforgivingly pounded. We lost so many, we have no hope. Many were young men on the shore of Gallipoli, leaving behind the comforts of family and home. They will always be an important part of history. Leaving the trenches was exhausting and hard. It was a constant struggle to stay alive. Those who survived were left as scar. I'm shocked anyone managed to live. So many innocent lives were lost. War takes so many lives away. But they were there to protect our country at any cost. And we will remember them with each poppy. Thank you.
Thank you very much there. Ahora toma la palabra para Francia, Prisca Vanier. Now we will say a few words, Prisca Vanier of France.
Muchas gracias, Gary. Voy a leeros un poema escrito por los alumnos de un colegio de Versalles para la celebración del acto del 11 de noviembre de 2018. Son alumnos de 12 y 13 años y el poema es sobrecogedor. this poem was written by pupils age 12 or 13 years from the Versailles College and written for the celebration of the 11th of 11, 2018. J'écris ton nom sur les no man's land défigurés, sur les barbelés rouillés, sur les paysages dévastés, j'écris ton nom. Sur le froid et dans l'effroi, sur la terre détrempée, sur le soleil effacé, j'écris ton nom. Sur les baïonnettes ensanglantées, sur les obus éclatés par milliers, sur les grenades mortifères lancées, j'écris ton nom. Sur les croix de bois des alliés, sur les casques de corps inanimés, sur les fusils des compagnons mutilés, j'écris ton nom. Sur les cigarettes partagées, sur l'amitié pour se réchauffer, sur la perte des frères des tranchées, j'écris ton nom. Sur le bonheur qui s'enfuit, sur les je t'aime au goût amer, sur les lettres d'amour inachevées, j'écris ton nom. Sur les larmes de mère éplorées, sur les cœurs brisés, sur le deuil de l'arrière délaissé, j'écris ton nom. Pour la mémoire de chacun, en souvenir de tous ces hommes tombés, et pour ne pas recommencer les erreurs du passé, je viens ici pour t'acclamer. Paix, peace, paz.
And this brings to a close today's International Armistice Commemoration. Thank you once again for all those who attended, and we wish to see you once more next year.
Muchas gracias a todos. Esto termina hoy nuestra ceremonia de conmemoración del Día del Armisticio. Nos gustaría terminar con una marcha junto con las gaitas del Sur Pipes Band y terminaremos fuera.
We will now finish with a march passed by the Sword Pipes Band, led by Leslie Thompson. And finally, I would just like to say a few words. When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today. Thank you.